Okay, good morning. I'd like to call the Stockbridge Bowl Stewardship Commission meeting to order for December 2nd, 2022. It's 8:02 a.m. So first order of business, I don't know if everybody got and had a chance to look at the minutes that were sent. So I had sent out the minutes for November 18th. And then Michael kindly helped me because I ended up having to go to work this week. Somebody was sick. So my plans were blown to pieces for the week. So anyway, and those I forwarded out last night because he did those yesterday. So did anybody get a chance to read any of these?
Yeah, I did.
I read them.
I commented and said, I need some editing, but.
I responded to you, yes.
The editing on which one? On the fourth?
Yeah, which one was it though? That's what I wasn't clear on.
Oh, I don't know. I only read one.
Might have been the 18th then.
Yeah.
Okay, so you said something about capitalization. I know that you don't want to be abbreviated as SUM. You want it to be SU, which is
right.
Fine.
Yeah.
I wasn't aware of that, so I apologize. But there was other just capitalization.
Yeah, I just needed, you know, I mean, I'd be happy to go through and sort it out if you want.
Well, maybe you shouldn't go through the November 4th either. If that needs editing.
But
anyway.
Well, I mean, can we, for the 18th, did anybody read them? Did you read them?
I read the one you sent yesterday.
Yeah, I read it.
I read it. I move it's accepted.
Yeah.
Pending. Grammatical and revision.
There he
Look
is.
Who's here.
Hey, we're just talking about you.
Worried about you, Mike.
All righty. So you moved. Did you second?
Yeah, I did.
All right. All those in favor, second in November 18th minutes.
But we're not going to edit any further?
Aye. No. Pending her.
Well, we can't approve them until we actually see the final ones.
No, based on her motion just now. She just
I understand, but you can't really approve minutes without seeing them. So, I mean, if we don't know what the edits are, you can't, you know, just.
Well,
just.
Why don't we just do it next next one after you.
Grammatical. We do this fairly frequently.
All right. It's up to you. I don't care.
Does the select
And
board?
Sally, how do you like to be with the initials?
SU.
Capitalism.
SU.
Yeah. Oh,
that's not what I, November 4th has.
All right, so I'm an I.
I am never Sally Miller.
It's an I.
Makes me cross.
Don.
Getting grumpy.
Well, don't
I don't approve in the minutes.
I approve.
Yeah.
All right.
Sorry about that.
All right, so the minutes for November 18th, 2022 have been approved. We'll hold off on the 4th because that's probably going to need significant work. That was a last minute dash with his help, so. He put in a lot of time yesterday, I know, but he came up with a great idea.
Well, I have to work on it.
Dictation in Word. And so he was playing the video and running the dictation, which I thought was clever. So,
well, I got to figure that out. I mean, it actually writes everything that's being said. And it does a 90%. The problem with that is that when you change speakers, it doesn't know. So you got to. So I got to play with it to see if it's of any help.
All right.
Yeah.
All righty. So I've got to go to here. Now, the next thing, I finally did get back yesterday afternoon and I was at work.
Can I just interrupt you one second? Can you just let us know who's here?
Who is here is Pat Canelli and Anita Schwerner.
Okay.
As far as I can see. That's,
welcome.
Yes. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Thanks for coming. So yesterday afternoon, I did get back from Steve Roy because I've been bugging him and I hadn't heard back and I was getting nervous, but they did incorporate the net benefit plan from the dredging. So that is now in here as a data source. And that's the only change. And the only other change that I made is because of Patrick's comment about he didn't really like the graphics. So I plugged in some pictures. So let's see if we can. Is that, it's not there, okay. So they did plug in the net benefit plan. And then I just changed some of these pictures that were in here for Patrick's benefit.
lovely.
Okay, so that's it.
All right.
And there was one or two that I didn't get to, but
Oh, you could put your own pictures? We could put our own pictures?
I did.
Yeah, good.
And Steve didn't say I couldn't, so I figured it was okay, but it was just, that was minor. So can we take a vote and agree to now pass this on to the select board?
I second that. Let's do it.
All right, so I make a motion that we pass it on to the select board. You second?
I do.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay.
Yay, congratulations.
The ball is over the finish line.
Do you want it on the agenda for this Thursday?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you can come and do your dog and pony thing.
Yep.
All right, great.
All righty, so the next thing on the agenda, but I don't see Jim Willis here, and was to talk about public awareness and education. So I don't know. Have any of you sent things in to Jim in the last couple of weeks, 2 weeks?
We have a meeting. Board of Health has a meeting scheduled probably the second week in this month. And I think we'll have something there. It's been postponed a little bit. We should have had it already, but for some reason it's been postponed.
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's the 12th.
Okay. Sally, have you sent him anything yet?
No.
Okay, Patrick?
Well, I gave you that one thing that, like a month ago.
Yeah. No?
I have one idea that
Okay.
came from a meeting we had with, what's his name?
Ken Gooch.
Ken, about the trees in Bullard Woods. He said there's a GPS-based program called Survey 123 or 123 Survey, which you can buy. It's about $2,700. And he said you can load it onto cell phones, things, and people can watch themselves walking through here and there. We can also use this on the lake for people to spot where, you know, to point where they've come upon some invasive species. I think this would be a wonderful thing to have. I mean, I'm working on that. I think it would be educational because we can also include things with it that people can have on their cell phones to read.
But you got to look, how many people can share this?
From what I understand, it's unlimited when you make the original acquisition.
The crowdsource thing. So you basically can pull up on a phone and it just stores in a central database for that account.
So the town buys, somebody buys it.
Shared.
And then they go on it from, anybody can go on it? It doesn't seem, there seems to be some missing link.
No, it's like, it's lots of apps. It's like,
oh, yeah?
Store apps and there's lots of.
Yeah, but $2,700 is what I'm trying to say. It seems like.
A lot of towns in the world.
The one time.
Software has a limitation.
Okay, I mean, just.
But I think it may not be seats.
I think it's probably geographic. I'm going to take a look.
Yeah, absolutely.
We should check it out.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, and what's the other one? Pat Canelli, remind me what the other one is called that is relatively inexpensive.
It's Picture This, I believe. I'm going to double check.
That is something else.
It's $30 a year.
Yeah, and that one.
That's just to identify.
That's to identify. So if somebody sees something suspicious and they want to identify a plant, you basically take a picture of it and it identifies it for you. It tells you what it is. So that's another option.
They're not as sophisticated as we might think.
Yeah.
But Ken also mentioned to us, he said some of these programs make a lot of mistakes.
Pat said she's tried this and it's worked.
Okay.
It's been successful.
Maybe it worked.
Actually, and I've had a picture before I had the app myself, and the person that did have the app took a picture of my picture and identified the plant that was in the outlet. So the Picture This is pretty good for both submersed aquatic plants, because I've tried it, but also, you know, plants that are on land.
Okay. All righty. Well, Mike Buffoni.
Hi, everybody.
Hi. As you can, like, move up to the table, you know. You don't have to sit way back there. But has Water Department shared anything with Jim Willis that he can?
I haven't, something I didn't know.
Okay, and I haven't heard from Jim, so I don't know why he's not here, but I'm sure he's busy. So the question is do we want to continue to discuss this, or do we just want to hold off until January when maybe we have compiled a lot more information?
Good idea.
Okay.
I think everybody's sort of, yeah.
Everybody's tired and everybody's scared for holidays and getting over a holiday and, yeah.
But that discussion should be had as a group, because I think we'll come up with ideas when you're with a group rather than just individually.
Absolutely. Just remember, though, you can all go to Jim. He said he would serve as the clearinghouse, and he would pull together all the information from all of us, because we're all going to have different perspectives, and we're all going to have different ideas. And I think it's important that we share it and just discuss it among ourselves.
In spite of the fact that we, many of us have, and myself included, given him, do we have anything that we've given Jim?
I have.
You have. So would you do, would you do us the favor, or do me the favor, and send that to give us a jumpstart on the ideas or what, how you see this happening, so that we can just take a look?
Okay. So I started to put together like a table or a spreadsheet or something, and I did send stuff to him initially. So yeah, I'll clean it up a little bit, make it a little prettier. I didn't have to make it pretty.
And send, if you can, send a copy to Pat.
Okay.
You know?
I can copy Pat, no problem.
Yeah, send a copy to Pat.
One thing on the public awareness that we did with Zebra years ago was trying to get the associations, like people rolling with Airbnbs, was like, just, they roll in with their car, they bring their canoe or kayak out, we don't know where they've been. That was, we thought of sticker things. I mean, I don't know if that's something that Jim, I mean, but then we put the signs up at all the spots where people like to launch rather than the boat ramp. That was a big public awareness thing that we had to overcome with the Zebra Mussel.
And I think that's a good point that did come up. It did get touched on, because Sally had brought up,
Canoe racks.
There's also realtors and anyone who has a rental. And I know Jim Willis does have access. He can get from the DOR the actual addresses of people that are running Airbnbs.
No, you can't get only those street address.
No, I've gotten it from Jim with a list of everybody. You don't get it just for the town. I had to like sort through it, and I had to sort it out and pull out Stockbridge separately. But no, I've gotten it from him before, and that's where he's gotten it from. You don't get anything about what they've collected, but you get their addresses. So,
okay.
But that's a good point. I mean, you've got people that are coming in and they're renting and maybe just for a weekend, but they're bringing their canoe or their kayak or something.
Yeah,
and
we don't know where they've been.
Yeah, exactly. But okay, so why don't we just put this off until our next meeting, which, let's look at the calendar. Should be January 6th.
Oh, there's no meeting? There's no other meeting this month?
No. We're not required to. We can if you would.
No. I would just
really like to meet on like December 23rd. That's okay with me. But I don't think
anybody's
going to
want. Do we have a Stewardship Commission holiday party that we're doing? Or
no, but I have one I have to go to in a couple of days and figure out what I'm going to make and what I'm going to give as a gift still. But anyway, I
have it on December 23rd. I will not be here for that.
There you go.
Saying, we're having Christmas on at our house on that day. So.
Oh, well, very nice. No, I think we all deserve a break.
January 6th.
Okay. And so January 6th would be the next scheduled meeting at 8 a.m.
Okay.
And so now, any questions or comments from the public, Anita or Pat? Do either of you have any questions or comments?
Roxanne, because the next meeting's in January, I am wondering, I had sent you a copy of the legal rationale that our attorney put together for increasing the harvesting permit. And I'm wondering, rather than lose an entire month before we get to January, if there's a way that I can move the ball forward on this in terms of either circulating it to the entire SBSC, or I'm just trying to figure out how to move it forward and not lose a month.
Well, have you sent it to Mike Canales?
No, and I can certainly do that. I'm looking for your advice about who needs to see this so that we can move forward. I think at one point we talked about potentially forwarding it to Foresight since they filed the original one for them to get their take on it. I don't want to overstep my boundaries, and I just want to know how to keep moving this ball forward.
Yeah, my gut reaction is I think that Mike Canales, number one, should see it along with the select board because this is an administrative thing, and he may, you know, their take on it, it may not go any farther.
Right.
And secondary that the SBSC actually see that, quite frankly. I think it's going to be more important down the road if it's pursued that the Conservation Commission see it, but.
They have to.
But I think that us weighing in on this, I think this is an administrative kind of function. And I think to not waste any time, that would be the way to go, is just to go through the town administrator and the select board and just get their take on it.
Okay, that's great. Patrick, does that sound right to you that I'll send it to Mike Canales? And then does Mike send it to the select board or shall I send it to all three members?
Just send it to all of us.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Will do, that's great.
Everybody here okay with that?
Yep.
You know, can you also send it to Sally? Sally has, you know, obviously the DEP consultant, the Fleetwood folks. And if we're talking about legal analysis, I would love to get, their take on whether it would fly.
Well, Mike can do that as well.
Yeah, but he works for the Conservation Commission, not for Mike.
Well, he works for the town.
Yeah.
Well, he actually works for the Conservation Commission, but yeah, that's fine.
But no, Mike has already said that to me. It's like, he doesn't, you know, he's already communicated with them about a couple of things. So he can utilize them as a resource.
Of course, yeah. You know, but yeah.
But either way, it doesn't matter. It's up to you, Sally.
So please send it to Sally as well.
I absolutely, Sally, if that's all right with you, I'll also send you a copy.
Sure.
Okay.
All righty. Any other questions, comments, concerns?
Are we doing the run through of the various, is that what we're doing now?
We can, yep.
I wanted to just raise the point that we just, we're just opening up the community preservation cycle, and January is a bit pushing the envelope in terms of when you think our review meeting is going to be.
It's usually early in February.
Early in February, okay. So we have some time to think about it, but you know, there's really kind of two questions I have about CPC. One is dredging, and the second is everything else. So I wanted to know if we want to kind of pursue any applications with CPC, and that's a good topic for us to think about this month and maybe address in January.
Yeah, because it'll be early January.
We'll probably have the public meeting in January.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. All righty. That all you got?
That's all I got.
Okay. Sally?
Got nothing.
John?
Nothing.
Gary? We know we had no zebra mussels from the last meeting.
It's pretty quiet right now.
Yeah, exactly. Michael?
I have I think what's important, we put in on this lake management plan that dredging was the most important project. Not, we didn't put in the lake management plan per se, we voted on it. But we need help in terms of getting Mike or whatever to contact GZA. Pat Canale, we had a meeting with Pat Canale and Ira, Vice President, and you, and about trying to be more diligent on being on top of GZA and contacting them, because NHESP, before they had a meeting with us, said that they want to see the lake management plan.
Yep.
But I think we need to set up, if we could just push Mike along, to have a meeting with GZA to see what the next steps are or what we have to do. And I think the idea, even if it's just touching base with them, the longer we have these periods of non-communication, the harder it is for them to jump on it, because
right,
they don't look at it as important as it is to us. To them, it's not as important if we're so all over the place.
And
so
when you say Mike, you're talking Mike Canales.
Mike Canales, I apologize, and I just said to other people we should say the last name, Mike Canales, but I'm the only one.
You're not talking about yourself?
No, I'm talking about Mike, right.
Oh, this Mike, right.
This
and
Mike.
Not this Mike.
Yeah, but anyway, I think we need to get Mike Canales on board of setting up a schedule or something.
Yeah, we had that.
And maybe we need Pat, you're there, right? To have set up a meeting for that, even among us, who met there.
Right. What we had talked about was setting up a scheduled meeting, a regularly scheduled meeting, so that we had regular updates, keep them on their toes.
Absolutely.
Like, keep us up to date.
How often do you think you need them?
Oh.
Every 6 weeks, maybe?
Four to 6 weeks.
You know?
You know, somewhere in that vicinity, so that this, you know, they just kind of don't shuffle this aside.
Once a month.
Well, that doesn't matter, but I think we're now more focused as a community.
But we've been trying to do that.
As to what we're doing.
And
I think now that we're more focused, I think everybody's on board, rowing in the same direction. I think it's very important that GZA understands that and that we communicate that to NHESP.
And the other thing I think that's important, and I think, though, we need the blessing of the select board at this point. So Thursday meeting, assuming that the select board accepts the lake management plan, then maybe we could take a vote right now that, assuming that they accept it, based on their acceptance, should we just go ahead and send it out to DEP and NHESP so they have it? Because we know they want to see this.
We don't need a vote on that. We can just do that.
Well, I want to know if everybody agrees that that's a good idea. If you don't think it's a good idea, let's
get it out there.
Fleetwood at the same time.
There's no reason to get it.
Well, and I put a call in to Mike Canales. I haven't heard back from him. I wanted to see if this had gone in front of Fleetwood yet. Because when I sent out, not this latest one with net benefit, but the one that we just agreed on in the last meeting, I sent it to Mike Canales thinking that he would like get it in front of Fleetwood. And I don't know if that's happened.
Can you send that to them today so that if they have any comments, we know before next Thursday?
I can.
I appreciate it.
And what I will do after, right after this meeting.
Can you send me the final document again, just to A, remind me, and B, make sure I've got the latest and greatest?
The latest one, because I haven't sent it yet. I just got it and downloaded it, so.
Because I don't know if he's in today. Is Michael in today, do you know?
I'm not sure.
But at any rate, yeah. I mean, do people feel comfortable with sharing this with NHESP and DEP knowing that they want to see this?
Is it a formalized, did they finish it with the changes? Did GZA incorporate everything? Is it a final thing? We're not sending them a pre-final thing.
But
I just want to make sure that yeah, it's a finalized version.
Look, I think that Sally, Roxanne, and I, if you want me involved, should get the feedback from Fleetwood and decide whether these are nominal changes or if they have anything of substance. And my suggestion would be that we schedule, I'll put it on the agenda, but if you feel like we need one more round of revisions, maybe we do at a meeting like in a week or two and we just,
And the other thing is you could invite Fleetwood to come to that particular meeting.
Yeah, but I don't want to, micromanage the, board needs to decide if.
Do we think they can get to it before your meeting?
Well, I hope so. That's why I wanted to send it. I didn't know. I didn't realize I hadn't seen it yet. Sorry.
I don't know whether they have or not.
And I don't know at this point. So, okay.
But I'll ask him that. Thursday,
I'm going to send
from yesterday, Thursday.
Yeah, we're going to put approve in it, but I kind of want them a set of, their review just.
You have to remember, though, that this can always be edited. I mean, discuss anything that needs to be changed. But the fact that we actually have a finalized lake management plan, I think, is going to be significant to NHESP,
particularly, imperative.
And DEP, because they're kind of chomping at the bit. They've mentioned it in emails, so.
Roxanne, it's Pat. Can we also send it to the other part of GZA, in other words, the Nat Arai part, who had met with NHESP, just to get their take on whether it's going to do what NHESP and DEP wants it to do?
Oh, sure.
Okay.
I'll send it to both offices of GZA. I mean, they have it in Hartford, obviously. They just sent it to us. And I'd be surprised if they didn't share it, but I will definitely share it directly with Nat Arai.
Thank you.
Okay. All righty, let me see. And Mike Buffoni, anything from Water Department?
We went out and did our last round of sampling and data collection the first week of November. And everything was still way down, behaving itself. Yeah, it stayed pretty level at between 9 and 11 meters all summer. And everything looked great, and we'll start back up in April. We did miss, I want to say we missed 2 months this year, just because we were so busy, we just could not get out. We missed October, and we missed, I think, July or June or something like that. So there's 2 months that are missing, but, you know, you can only do what we can do.
You know, one thought that I've had about this is, I don't, you know, I'm sure it's historically documented what the weather has been in each year, because it's interesting this year that the cyanobacteria has remained low and we didn't have a turnover. And versus 2018 when we had the bloom, the cyanobacterial bloom. And my question is, we know we had the higher temperatures this year, but did we have any major wind events?
Yeah.
In July and August.
On that one, when we had the bloom, it was very dry that year. And right after it, we had, right prior to the bloom, we had, was it the remnants of a hurricane or something? Or
yeah. We had a big rain,
like 3 inches of rain or something like that. And then, you know, it happened. But we have, it seems like it's windy every day this past summer. And of course it was dry, but it was really bizarre because we kept, you know, we go in the outlet and we take a sample in the outlet every month as well. And it wasn't really low. The lakes held its level pretty well for how dry it really was.
I was going to ask you that taking the harvester out, I was always amazed how high the lake remained.
Yeah.
Even during no rain air time. And I'm just wondering, is that spring? Is that?
It's the same springs issues we talked about for, you know, Lake Everett, you know.
Yeah.
There's something like 2/3, they estimated something like 2/3 of the water source is coming from the ground, not from
rain
runoff. Yeah.
The water temperature didn't even bump 80 this year. I didn't see it.
Yeah, I'm not 100%. I have all the data because we start at 1 meter. So,
yeah.
And usually the first, it's bizarre that the first 10, 15 feet of water temperature was like really consistent on the same. So it was pretty interesting. But anyway, like I said, coming back up,
April
will send the sound out to the animal maintenance. They go through the whole thing and all that. And
someone's leaving their faucet on.
The only thing that's
leaving
tough
their
is
faucet on, right?
Running the samples around. It's, you know, not only do we have to go out and get all the stuff and collect all the data, it's just running the Westfield or Springfield or wherever. It's a little bit.
You can't ship them?
No, we have to go meet a courier. So Mark takes a set of samples for Bob Cordman to Pittsfield to FedEx, and then I run to Westfield at the old, I meet somebody at the old Friendlies that's right there at exit 3 or whatever exit it is now, 40 or whatever. It's a little bit.
Our samples get processed at Friendlies?
Huh? Okay. Yeah. So anyway, it is what it is.
Like you're having a drug.
Right, exactly.
And the last time, the back of the Friendlies is all tagged with graffiti, and I'm looking around. A lot of people park there. The carpool out of there. Right. But anyway.
So, yeah, I mean, you're handing it off to somebody, and that's a courier then that's
Phoenix,
transporting?
Phoenix, and Ty and Bond right down the street, so they go to Ty and Bond and grab samples all the time as well. So
right.
I schedule a courier the day before.
I mean, is there a way that would be more convenient for you? Because this obviously takes a lot of your time. I mean, could the town hire a courier to get it there?
Get a volunteer.
I've asked, but I don't think it doesn't sound like they want anything to do with them coming out here and grabbing the samples. But it's something to think about over the winter.
It's not a great use of your time.
It's once a month, it's one day, and it's usually with going up and getting the samples, collecting everything. If all the brooks are running, it's a whole day.
Right.
It's a whole day event.
Unless you can get a fribble, though, right?
Not now. It's closed.
It's closed.
Has been. So anyway.
It's depressing.
That'll be interesting to see the way they compile the data and get the report.
When do you get the report, you know?
I don't get it.
Cordman gets it?
The only thing they send me is the invoice, and then I send it.
So who gets it? Cordman gets it, or?
They produce it, and then I think it just must go to the select board or something.
We know?
Yeah, it comes to the town administration.
Right.
It comes to the town administration.
It should probably come to the Conservation Commission, too.
Uh-huh. Can you, right, you'll let us know?
No, I said it should come to the
Oh, it should. I thought you said it.
Once it comes in, I'll put it. Bugging Mike's here. Once it comes in, I pass it around.
Yeah.
Can we?
Well, it comes in and then typically gets distributed to the SBSC. Everybody gets a copy once we get those reports. And if I forget, just remind me. But typically they come in and they come into the town administrator, and they might come into me now as the chair. But then as the chair, I can send it to everybody that's on the commission.
Yeah, I think that's to see it.
Anyway, so, but the one thing I was wondering is that the documentation of the historic temperature data and weather data, you know, significant weather events, and whether or not we should really be incorporating that into this. So that's a question for Steve Roy, I think, at GZA, and just say, hey, don't you think that would be a good idea? Because then you can more precisely compare one year to another when you have a very different experience like this year, to try to drill down and look at, well, what's different? What's changed? What, and over a longer period of time, obviously, you got to do this for years and years, but we're going to be doing this for years, is then maybe you can start drawing some inferences from what that, the, you know, if you see something that happens and it happens again 5 years later, and you've got a common event or series of events weather-wise, then maybe you can draw some inferences from
and
that.
And we, as the water department, I think since the 1920s, we've been a weather spotter for DCR, so we can also give them all of our local rain and snow or rain data from, and I'm sure you can look it up on NOAA's website too, but we have all the rain data that we collect at the treatment plant as well.
Okay, good.
So it's more of a local plan,
right?
Weather normalizer or whatever, however they would do it.
Okay, wonderful. Okay, anything else from anyone?
I think last time we talked about the dam, and I hadn't had a chance to talk to Mike about exercising that valve. That was brought up the last meeting.
Yeah.
I mean, is that something you're going to do, or?
So was there like a CONCOM thing involved with that, or?
Yeah.
No,
I think it's just a matter of
make sure it doesn't seize up.
Mike, what I was concerned, I mean, Gary and I have worked, Gary mainly, but is the worry of it freezing or, you know, like since it hasn't been used for basically 2-3 years, just to make sure that it's working for any emergency.
Yeah, bring your grease gun with you.
Yeah.
And
you have the
one of the arms is not working well, but it
does it have fittings on there for a grease gun?
Zerks, yeah.
Oh, that's easy to do.
Yeah.
But it, we've been told that that's pretty much indestructible.
No, I understand, but I grew up in a factory. It never hurts to turn that thing once. Yeah.
Because the ice gets in there and
who knows? Who knows? These machines have a mind of their own.
Yeah, it's just a big threaded, bronze threaded post. So, yeah, we can.
Okay. All right. So right after the meeting, I'm going to send this latest and greatest final version to everybody here. And you will get this on the agenda for the next select board meeting, and we'll go from there. So anything else?
One last thing. Should we be bringing Michael Canales in to discuss how we deal with GZA? I mean, in other words, like, and when I say deal, I mean in a positive, that to set up, like we'd like to.
We're doing like a monthly.
A monthly or 6 weeks or something. Something that I feel he needs to be. He wasn't at our meeting that we had.
Right.
But I think it's important that I think it will be more important to him to do it if he's at one of these meetings and seeing and hearing it from us.
Well, there's the boss over here.
All right. If you could.
The boss can tell him.
Think about that. Yeah.
It's a higher priority.
Because Greg, I don't think Greg is going to do it. So I think it's really Michael Canales that
has
to do it.
Greg has tried. I mean, I've seen the emails and I know.
Well, I didn't get.
A number of.
Yeah, no. I understand that. I just think that it's not in his whatever. I mean, he's.
Well, and as the town administrator, he carries more weight.
Yeah.
So I think that.
Yeah. Well, Greg is
pretty good. It's
much more
likely if he makes that request and or the select board chairman makes that request.
Right.
Then it will happen. Okay.
When was the last meeting?
With GZA?
Well, the last one similar to this, the one that you're looking for.
Oh. GZA meeting was probably 6 months. I'd have to look. My memory is.
So too long.
Way too long.
Okay.
Way too long.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
All right. Anything else?
Okay.
So I move to adjourn.
Okay.
So moved. Thank you.
And we'll see you next year, right?